Ladies and gentlemen, people of the internet, and you mutated weirdos. Welcome to the show. Y'all seemed to like it when I took a look at Temtem, so once again I will put on the big rubber glove and dip my hand into the bowels of early access. Oh look, a first-person shooter. This is underdeveloped. Heathen, the sons of the law. It's a first-person shooter set in a world similar to, but I'm sure legally distinct from, that of the island of Dr. Moreau, filled with half-animal, half-human mutants. Oh. I'm hearing from Doug that the game hasn't been updated in a year. What's that? What? Oh, and apparently their social media is almost dead. Ha. So this looks like it could be another early access game that doesn't make it across the finish line. But the developers have said they will update the game coming in spring of 2020, and that the lack of updates is because the initial sales weren't enough for them to develop the game full time. And you know, unfortunately, this can be the vicious cycle in early access games, in indie games in general. You don't have the time or resources to finish your game, and so it's unpolished. Then because of its unpolished state, it doesn't get a lot of traction for early access sales. So then you have low sales, so then you don't have the time or resources to finish your game. I like early access games, just like I like commentary tracks on movies or behind the scenes featurettes. For me, the process of how art is made can be just as interesting as the art itself. Heathen, the Sons of the Law, is a game that's finished enough where you can imagine what the final product will look like, but still in such a rough state that you can kind of see how the sausage is being made. Currently in the game, there is no story element and very little world set up. So basically, I'm gonna dive right into the gameplay. All you really need to know is that it's based off of the island of Dr. Moreau, so you got these mutated animals. The big hook for Heathen, the Sons of the Law, is that you are a half-human, half-beast mutant. And you can toggle between your two states, human and beast. Blah. Both states have their own advantage and disadvantage. As a beast, you can run faster, jump higher, and use like your claws to attack. But you need to be in your human state if you want to heal or use guns or even open a door. So, what ends up happening is while you're in combat or just exploring the world, you'll find yourself toggling back and forth between beast and human mode. It's a little frantic and chaotic, and I mean that in a very good way. It really fits the tone and theme of the game. But none of these ideas are really expanded on. You know, like maybe there could have been some branching upgrade paths. Like, like, you know, you get to choose whether you want to be more beastly or more humanly, huh? That would have been cool. I mean, I am going to complain about Heathen, the Sons of the Law, a fair bit, but overall, I really liked it. And a lot of the reason I think I liked it was because of its cohesive tone. There is this feeling that you are scrambling to survive, like kind of like danger lurks around every corner and you are just barely making it out alive. And while you can't upgrade or change your beast attacks, you do find new weapons around the island. You know, your standard FPS fare. You got your crossbow, your rifle, your sniper rifle, your shotgun, both standard and double-barreled variety. And near the end of the game, they tease a fancy, you know, it's like a lightning gun. But that's right when you reach the end, so you don't actually get to use it against anyone. But you know, it's there. All the guns feel nice and weighty. There's a satisfying kickback and blood spray when using the shotgun. And the developers made a couple great decisions theming the guns with the tone of the game. Namely, iron sights and limited ammunition. So to help with that tone, that kind of uneasy combat feeling, you shouldn't be able to aim precisely. So they give you iron sights. Your gun wobbles and kicks back with every shot, making every miss build that tension. Speaking of missed shots, while I didn't find myself running out of ammo often, it happened enough where I felt a need to conserve ammunition. Adding to that is you have to pick up each bullet individually, and so there is a hoarding thing. Oh, do I want to use my shotgun? I only have 12 shotgun shells left. It definitely helps build that tension. And I know I say this a lot, but only because it's one of the key elements to literally almost all entertainment, but it's all about the build and release of tension. It's managing all of these variables, your ammunition counts, your health, your beast mode meter, the enemy charging down at you. It makes victory feel satisfying because they're able to get you tense, and then victory is the release. But remember, the game's not quite finished yet. The enemy AI is... Okay, there's a couple problems here. One of them is stealth. There is this little indicator on your HUD that lets you know if you are hidden or if an enemy can see you. And this is the biggest joke of the game. Besides one stealth tutorial section, the enemies can see you. They can always see you. You can be crouched in the tall grass, being obstructed by palm trees, and the enemy is 30 yards away behind a wall in their tower, and they can shoot at you with the accuracy of a veteran military sniper. You cross this invisible line and suddenly all guns are magnetically attracted to your hitbox. It's incredibly infuriating because most of the time you can't see them. In fact, my usual strategy is just to wait until they shoot me so I can see their muzzle flash. That's the only way I could return fire. On the other side of that spectrum, but equally disappointing, is finding that invisible line that resets the enemy's position. There were a few fights that I was able to cheese pretty hard because I would cross that line and then like watch all the enemies slowly back up and return to zero. And while it was pretty funny to watch, it made the fight pretty lame. Level design and backtracking. So much backtracking. In between fights, you are often tasked with obtaining an object. You know, for example, you need to get into a base, but the gate is locked, and you find this monster who, for some reason, is not trying to kill you. And then you see this little prompt that says you need some fish. So you go out and get the fish and bring them back. Then the prompt says you need a harness. So you go out again and get the harness. And then there's a new prompt that says you need some rope, so you go out again and get some rope, only to have the monster harnessed to the rope by the fish. And then the prompt says you need more fish. That is four trips out and back again to open one door. That's what we refer to in the business as padding the runtime. And it's always bullshit. Always. But to swing this train back into Positivity City, there was some really excellent design when it came to exploring the world. I came across this area and it had some like random trash strewn about it, and there were some wood and stuff on the walls, including this broken ladder. And you know, why would a ladder be there? Well, I looked up and sure enough, there was this little space for me to jump up to. And I don't know, this might not seem like a big deal, but often in level design, you won't see this attention to detail. Developers will place things just kind of wherever, just to make a room look busy. But here's a situation where I felt rewarded for noticing an object and making a logical deduction. Also, there is some genuinely creepy atmospheric stuff. The first time I came across a screamer in an old abandoned house, I was terrified. It was great. Also, there are these sections filled with deadly gas, and you need to wear a gas mask. And when you have the mask on, it blurs your vision and makes it so you can't see an enemy until they're right in front of you. Just phenomenal visuals and great tension building. Heathen, the Sons of the Law, is a good game, and it actually has a lot of personality oozing out of the stock assets. There are a lot of solid ideas in there and some gameplay moments that legitimately stick the landing. I'm really hoping the developers continue to work on this game because right now in its early access state, it's hard for me to recommend to everyone. You can't make that blanket statement because it is so unpolished. But at the same time, if you were thinking about dipping your toe into this world, the world of unfinished games, Heathen, the Sons of the Law, might be a good place to start. Or it might make you sick. I'm saying it will make you literally sick because you can't go into the graphics settings and turn off motion blur. It's just something you can't do right now.